me, I wanted the costume design to feel like a historical movie. To move away from fantasy, to be more grounded into the reality of what the character, the environment, the climate, what the character were experiencing, their social position.
For me, from the beginning, the House of Atreides, my inspiration was the Romanovs. And the Zhivago shirt made it into the movie as the Atreides uniform shirt. We futurized it with rare earth magnets, but it's a classic, classic piece. And then Paul Atreides, to me, has always been Lawrence of Arabia. How he's dressed in the desert is with the head wraps and the cloaks was my homage to David Lean and the desert scenes.
These were the Duke's armored pieces. This is without the armor on it. We created these costumes, which is the carrier for the armor. So much like a SWAT gear or a armored vest over, you know, over what we'd call a BDU or a battle dress uniform. So we basically built it like a real army. This is the Atreides green. Their dress uniform is the same shade because they came from a very cool, rainy planet. It was very, you know, lush and dense and rain, so we worked with a color that was kind of that world and not like Arrakis, which was really color defined into sand and beige and, you know, mixing with those rocks and sand.
This is Duke Leto's dress uniform. We put the rankings in here. They get stitched in for the various officers.
Come here, kneel.
There is so much attention brought to making these costumes believable, but also the sense of trying to go back to Frank Herbert's essence. Specifically for Jacqueline, she talked a lot about referencing tarot and chess boards because Frank Herbert loved to play chess and, you know, to have his cards read.
Mother Mohayam's character really came from the tarot and the chessboard. I had done Knight of Cups with Terrence Malick, and so I bought the definitive Marseille tarot, and she came right out of the tarot and was the queen from the most exotic chess piece you could ever find.
If you keep moving Mother Mohayam, this was how her cloak in the library when she does the test, the human test with Paul, is what she wore.
Put your right hand in the box. Your mother bade you obey me.
Lady Jessica's wardrobe, she goes from being very nun-like and a very dark wardrobe on Caladan to a brighter, sunlit, sun-kissed wardrobe.
Jessica was the one piece of color in that world.
This is one of Lady Jessica's dress, again, with the hood, a very austere but queenly. The royal concubine. This is the scene, the cloak she wears where she greets Mother Mohayam on Caladan.
We both said that she needs to be so clean. We had the most exquisite ideas, and sometimes they were too exquisite. And that's probably one of the things I love, to peel back and peel back.
This is all Lady Jessica's jewelry for her different dresses and outfits. This goes up her arm. She wore this in the photo shoot, along with the baby finger. All the incredible jewelry that between Ruben and Zoltan and Drea, they've designed, which could be probably the most fabulous jewelry line ever.
My desert, my Arrakis, my Dune.
The very first conversation with Denis, he said, how do you see the Baron? And I said, well, kind of like Kurtz in Apocalypse. And he goes, he's that kind of dark, heart of darkness kind of character. The Harkonnens are very arachnid, bug inspired, with layers and scales and crusts, and very, even their helmet is very ant-like, and the bodies are spider-like, whereas the Sadakor are more like gladiators, the creatures of the night.
The Abura Garanzin, Atatan,
This is a costume that's in three parts. It is blood, but it is also their insignia. And so they also have this logo, but it was kind of a mixture of blood and marking. So it was kind of a soldier's mark in a way, like, so they're not all the same, but you can see they're quite vicious fighters that they are the imperial fighters.
These are all of the Harkonnens lined up that were made here in Hungary by an incredible sculptor. Gergé Hatay did the actual production of them, and I think he did the most beautiful job.
I love the Harkonnen, and it is wonderful to make something that had not been seen before and definitely create a force that you are frightened of.
And it might change fashion next year.
Don't be frightened. Even a little desert mouse can survive.
I want to talk about Keith Christensen. He's a brilliant sketch artist, and he had been working on this before we came on, and he had actually drawn a version of the stillsuit. It was one of the only drawings that Denis brought forward and put in front of us when he hired us as an image of the stillsuit, which he said was the most important costume of the film, and it had been Keith's.
A friend will help you.
There was something about those stillsuits that were very practical. There was a utilitarianness to it. Maybe speaking for myself, but I felt myself come to when I put it on.
Tell me about the costumes. How they held up within the elements? How you found all that?
It's done really well. If anything, it's added a lovely patina to the costume, and just the natural dust. We do a lot of aging and textile work on the costumes, but just this lovely kind of sand that's constantly blowing through them makes a beautiful patina, and they've held up well. I mean, we're doing a lot of stunts, we're doing things, and we always have repairs and things we need to do to change, like a costume for a stunt, or make it softer, or make it more durable, but no, they've held up remarkably well.
Follow the friend.
I mean, the costumes were gorgeous, you know, like the way they fit everyone, the way there was like little details like, on my boots because, you know, maybe she had personalized her still suit a little bit. There was like little beads on the bottom of my boots to make something that's just like a gray thing look so beautiful. I don't know how they did it.
We walked back here, then we might even have someone kind of in a partial one. Denis had talked about, you know, we do the wraps on people, but they also have talisman. Ruben and his team, David and their team, created a lot of these talisman that each one, Jackie loved the idea, and Denis loved that it would have like some personalization, that they would have a charm or something that of their world, personal to them, like a soldier would. We treated it in that way, let them personalize their still suits.
Then we decided to add robes to add the color of spice and sand, but also to add something that would flow out beyond the body in the wind and give some romance and some beauty to a already beautiful still suit. But it was just an added layer for richness. As soon as you put flowing gauze over a human body that's already a beautiful shape and let the wind just take it, it's about as romantic as flowing fabric in the wind can get.
This is only the beginning.